And they're like, okay, well, it's another guy coming in, right? So they don't buy microgreens. It's just another one of these local farmers that comes in, tries to sell them for 2 months, and then it's gone, and they got to have, then they have a gap again. Then they go back to the national distributors, and they go out to, and they got to find a new guy. The flip-flop is what really kills these guys. That's why you see this hesitancy from wanting to meet with local guys, because they're not usually reliable, to be perfectly honest. But you can, and it just takes a while to establish that. But hey, if we say we're going to be there at 10 o'clock on a Tuesday, you're there, it'll blow their mind. It's like, well, you actually said we showed up. It's amazing, right? Sorry, we didn't come out today. You know, something happened to the house. Like, we had all the time from local guys at my restaurant where, hey, sorry, something came up. Like, well, we need your product. Okay, we'll try to get it out tomorrow. We need it today. We're going to vent tonight. Okay, sorry. And that was literally my conversations with a lot of guys. And that, it permeates, right? And chefs talk with other chefs. Build a continual, stable relationship with your guys, and it's amazing where you'll go in that industry for sure.
Yeah. Well, I mean, even with the big national shooters like US Foods, when I was a line cook, you know, you'd have that truck rolling. It was